Hi, this is Ray Price, and I'm going to be on the Ralph Emery Show real soon, and I hope you'll be listening. Hello, everybody. Welcome again to our show. This is Ralph Emery from Dallas, Texas. We normally do not take our show on the road, but we have come to Dallas, Texas, so that you could listen to our special friend, Ray Price. Ray, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Ralph, and welcome to Dallas.
I thank you very much. Our show is presented by Beechnut Chewing Tobacco, your local True Value hardware stores, and by America's number one pain reliever, Bayer Aspirin. Ray, you've relieved a lot of pain with your music, haven't you?
Yeah, and I've caused a lot of pain.
How are you getting along?
Oh, I'm doing pretty good. You know, it's not easy to be a farm boy.
Are you a farm boy?
I'm a farm boy.
Oh, come on. You mean you actually get out and slop the hogs and
no,
milk
and feed? Don't have no hogs. Cost too much money to have hogs anymore.
What have you got?
Gold got a few cows and a few chickens and a few horses.
I'm going to ask you about that as we go along.
Okay.
Why don't we get into a little music?
Anytime.
Now, there have been two versions of this song recorded, I believe.
Right. One in 1956 and one in about 1970 or 71, somewhere along there.
All right. And the original version was the record of the year, as I recall.
Right. 1957.
And then later on, you did an updated version.
Right.
So here's a Ray Price classic. We'll open the show with Harlan Howard's old tune, Heartaches by the Number.
Heartache number one was when you left me. I never knew that I could hurt this way. And heartache number two was when you came back again. You came back and never meant to stay. Now I've got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number, a love that I can't win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end. Heartache number three was when you called me and said that you was coming back to stay. With hopeful heart I waited for your knock on the door. I waited, but you must have lost your way. Now I've got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number, a love that I can't win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end.
I got to ask you, Ray, before I leave that tune alone, it's always confused me. Is it Heartaches by the Number or Numbers?
Numbers, I believe.
Is that the way you sing it?
That's the way I sing it.
Let me hear you sing a little bit.
Just Heartaches by the Numbers.
Numbers.
Trouble by the score.
Okay. Because I wondered how you could have more than one heartache and have only one number.
Right. It's Heartaches by the Numbers.
All right. You've heard Ray Price open our show with Heartaches by the Numbers. Fire can strike any time, anywhere, without warning. So True Value Hardware Stores suggest you safeguard your family night and day with a Home Sentry smoke alarm by General Electric. You mount it on the ceiling, it'll detect smoke before you could even see it, and sound a loud warning that could save your family's lives. It's available in house current or battery-operated models. Prices start at $28.88. The General Electric Home Sentry Smoke Alarm, just one of the many values at participating True Value Hardware stores.
Wasn't that a terrific lecture?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm Thelma Winter.
Oh, Sims. Dr. Sims.
Doctor?
Uh-huh.
Oh, say, I've got this headache.
Oh, Thelma.
Luckily, I had a couple of Bayer with me. Bayer aspirin works fast. I mean, nothing's faster.
Uh-huh.
But now you're the doctor. What would you recommend?
Probably Plato.
Plato. So what kind of a doctor?
I'm a doctor of philosophy.
A philosophy. You could get in trouble giving out medical advice.
Get Bayer aspirin. Use only as directed.
Ray, here in Dallas this morning, I have been by your office, and I understand that you live around here somewhere. You have two places that you hang out, don't
right,
you?
Right. I live not far from the office.
You have a house here in Dallas?
House in Dallas, and then I stay on the ranch most of the time.
Now, I've got to tell you, I'm lost.
Mm-hmm.
So where am I in Dallas?
Well, you're in North Dallas right now, and that's where I live, is in North Dallas.
And then how far is the ranch from here?
About 120 miles. Back to the... Well, it's not really a ranch. It's only 200 acres.
Oh.
But,
down in Texas, they don't call that a ranch?
That's a little bitty place here in Texas. Right. Some of the farms down there are 5,000 acres or more. So, but anyway, it's about 25 miles from where I was born, near Perryville, Texas.
You think you'll ever move to the ranch?
Well, that all depends on... who I'm married to at the time. I don't
see.
Know where Janie's going to move to the ranch or not.
I heard
she looked blank on that one, didn't she?
Janie, Mrs. Ray Price is sitting in the control room listening to all this, and I understand she's trying to keep you in Dallas.
Every chance she gets, I'll guarantee you, but kind of hard to do because I love to go down there. She loves it down there, but of course we have to stay in town and work and support our office staff.
I see. The office staff is also in the control room.
Right.
They probably are wondering if, you know, if they're going to get a raise or get fired. I may ask you those questions.
Well, if they ever get me into the office over there, they'll wish they hadn't. They're planning now a new major move to a new office and right away. And they figure they're going to fix me an office over there. Now, there might be a lot of people fired if I ever get over there.
You mean you don't want to go to the office?
That's it.
Tell me about this song, Ray. Now, people that follow your career know that for years you were on Columbia Records. You are now on ABC.
Right.
In the ABC complex.
Right.
Do I understand correctly that this is the last Columbia record?
It's the last album that they have. They have three or four more songs. But this is the last album.
And this is this particular song is from the last album.
This is from the last album.
This is awful pretty. How long ago did you do this?
Oh, I recorded this last year, Ralph. And in fact, about a year ago is when I recorded it.
You were still under contract to them.
Right.
All right, here's Ray to sing If You Ever Change Your Mind.
Girl, it can't go on like this. You say you're feeling trapped and locked in, and you long to see the part of life you've missed, and travel roads to places you ain't been. You know I hate to see you go, especially after all this time. So here's one thing I think that you should know. I'll be here if you ever change your mind. I'll be here if you ever change your mind. I know the time has come when you must see your own way. And if that's how it's got to be, I can only hope you find the road someday that brings you back to me. I know this life has got you down. Waking up each day to face the same old grind. But if there's no one selling dreams in town, I'll be here if you ever change your mind. I'll be here if you ever change your mind.
If you ever change your mind. Why don't you bring on somebody? This is out of a new album.
Okay. I'd like to say that I know this young lady. In fact, I was at the Louisville, Kentucky Fair the other day, and she was playing there the next day, and I had a chance to see her and her pretty little girl that she carries with her, and they was having a big time at the fair, and they was there with Mac Davis. And I'm speaking, of course, about Lynn Anderson and a great country song, and it's called A Good Old Country Song.
There's nothing like a guitar to make you want to pat your feet, or the sound of a fiddle when somebody plays it sweet. Add a banjo with steel bass and drums and you can't go wrong. Mix it all with the lyrics that makes you want to sing along.
Play me a good old country song. Do it in C or G and I'll sing along.
I just can't groove to rock and roll, rhythm and blues or hot buttered soul. So
play me a good old country song.
That's Lynn Anderson on our show. The little girl you had reference to is Lisa.
That's right.
We had Lisa on this show. I think when Lynn did the show, she couldn't find a babysitter. She couldn't find Glenn. And, so she brought Lisa, and Lisa proved to be a delightful guest when we could keep her in the chair.
Oh, yeah, she's that age where she's like a wiggle worm, you know.
Well, I didn't say all that, but... we kept her quiet for a while, and she answered the questions, and then she'd get down and want to go to the candy machine or the Coke machine or something like that.
Yeah, she was having a good time at the fair.
You've heard Lynn Anderson on this show, Lynn singing a good old country song.
We work in the sky where the steel grows high, me and my river Toulouse. Look out for each other like brother for brother, and beach nuts the tobacco we chew. There's no time to daydream, crawling on a steel beam, imagine what that teaches you. There's no maybe or might, friend, it had better be right. So beach nuts the tobacco you chew. When it comes to a man's chewing tobacco, it's gotta be right. Beach nuts got that real tobacco taste you want. Rich, smooth, satisfying. Taste that stays that way all chew through. Try beech nut chewing tobacco. Once you do, you've got a friend for life. Your buddy's no stranger when you're sharing the danger, and he's more than a friend to you. The chances we take don't allow for mistakes, and beech nut's the tobacco we chew.
Ray, how about your horses? How many have you got out there on the farm?
Oh, about 40. I've cut down a little bit and trying to upbreed the stock, and which is a constant thing in raising horses. You always have to try to improve. So that means you have to, as your brood mares get older, you have to kind of willow and winnow them out, and then you bring in new blood and try to make it successful.
You are a horse breeder then?
Right.
I might add that Jim Adams in there told me you know everything about horses.
So well,
I don't know anything about horses. You just ask Ray.
I don't know all that much. I know a little bit. I know one thing, that they all have good appetites.
What does it cost to, let's say a fellow wants to buy a thoroughbred horse. That's what you have, mm-hmm. racing stock.
Right.
Let's take one horse. What does it cost to raise him, feed him, keep him?
Well, it depends upon, there's two things there, Ralph. If you own the stallion, you own the mare, then it's not going to cost you as much. And you want to breed to as good a stallion as you can, and you want as good a mare as you can get. One that has either come from a proven family or one that has raced and proved herself on the racetrack. You can go as high as having a couple of $100,000 in one, or you can go as low as $500. Of course, it won't be much if you just got $500 because you didn't feed him. But to raise one properly and feed him, grain him, take care of him, and all the medications you have to give them, because they're like children, they get sick, and all of their vaccination shots, again, just like children, you have, I would say, before you get to the track, if you own the mare and the stallion, you've got to have, before you sell them at 15 months old, so you got to have, I'd say, from $1,500 to $2,000 or more, depending on what's happened to this particular horse during his lifetime, from the time he was foaled. And you've got a lot of money invested and a lot of time. Then when you go to the track, it even costs more money because of the prices, everything's so high.
It sounds a little expensive for my blood. Right?
Well, a horse has got to win about $7,000 a year just to break even.
And in 15 months, you'd spend $2,000 on it.
Right. So you buy him, and then you got another $7,000 in him right away during the first year of his racing. And if you're not particular who's training your horse, he may never get to the track.
And this is what people do when they bet on horses that don't come in. Here's Joe Stampley to sing Cry Like a Baby.
When I think about the good love you gave me, I cry like a baby. Living without you is driving me crazy. I cry like a baby. I know now that you're not a plaything. You're not a toy or a puppet on a string. I cry like a baby. Every road is a lonely street. I cry like a baby. I know now that you're not a plaything, not a toy or a puppet on a string. Today we passed on the street, and you just walked on by. It wants to get up again to cry.
That's old Joe Stampley from Spring Hill, Louisiana, singing Cry Like a Baby. I'll bet there are a lot of you country music fans who don't have a subscription to Music City News. This is the publication the fans refer to as the Bible of country music. Don't wait to get in on the country music excitement and enjoyment you'll find in your mailbox every month when you start your subscription to Music City News. Do it today. Send your check or money order for $7 to Ralph Emery, Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee. That's $7 to Ralph Emery, Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee. Here's Loretta Lynn singing from the collector's edition of Gospel Songs album we have for you.
I like the old time, preach and pray and sing and shout.
I want to send you this big two-record album with Ray Price, Loretta Lynn, Glenn Campbell, Ernest Tubb, and so many more. All you do is send a check for $5.98 to me, Ralph Emery, 110 21st Avenue South in Nashville, or Box 61, Nashville, Tennessee, 37203.
How my heart would beat with joy to hear.
Hey, Ray, I'm going to ask you to bring out somebody else here. Do you know Jesse Coulter?
Yes, I do now. since you reminded me who she is, and of course she's Waylon Jennings' wife and does a very good job.
This is her newest record, the follow-up to I'm Not Lisa, Miss Jesse Coulter with What's Happened to Blue Eyes.
What's happened to Blue Eyes? Has anyone seen him? Don't anyone tell me that he gave up on me. I'm looking for Blue Eyes. Has anyone known him? Is anyone know? What's happened to Blue Eyes?
Well, let me look at your eyes, Ray.
They're not blue no more.
Ah, yeah, yes. Well, I know the answer to that one. Blue Eyes is in Dallas. Okay, you've heard Jesse Coulter on the show singing What's Happened to Blue Eyes. You're listening to the Ralph Emery Show, and this is Ray Price week on the show. We're in Dallas, Texas. Ray, I must tell you, this is a first. We have never taken our show on the road before. Now, we've taken it out of our home base a couple of times. We did Johnny Cash at his House of Cash. I did Charlie Pride one day at the RCA studio in Nashville, and I did Glenn Campbell in a recording studio in Nashville. But never have we gone out of Nashville with our show. And we're delighted to be here with you in Texas.
Well, we appreciate you thinking that much of us and coming down here, Ralph. It's a great show, and of course, I'm always pleased to be on it. And you and I have been friends for many, many years, so...
Oh, don't tell them.
No, I won't tell them how long. I don't do that no more.
What's the next song here, Ray?
Well, this is a song written by my friend Jimmy Weatherly, and it's a great song, I think. It's called The Father's Thing from My Mind.
She She was everything in life I'd ever dreamed of. And more than I ever hoped I'd find. And to think that I would ever lose her sweet love was the farthest thing from my mind. I know that she could never purposely hurt me. She could never be that unkind. And to think that she would ever desert me was the farthest thing from my mind. She tripped over dreams that belonged to someone else and fell into his world and out of mine. And I'm not blaming her, but I don't blame myself. It's just the place and the time. I'll always believe she really loved me. Faith was the thief that robbed me blind. And I believe as sure as there's a sky above me, it was the farthest thing from her mind. It was the farthest thing from her mind.
Ray Price, a singing son of a gun. Was this your debut record over at ABC?
It was on the Mer label, which was a subsidiary of ABC.
Yeah, but this is after you had made the change.
This is after I made the change.
Because you were on Columbia Records a long time,
right? Right, 25 years.
I thought we weren't going to tell them.
Well, I started when I was 10.
Oh. You've heard Ray Price sing The Farthest Thing From My Mind. Ray, I haven't been out to your ranch. I can only ask you about it. And on this trip, I'm not going to have enough time to go out there. But I wondered if you have a lot of people working out there, or if you do the work yourself.
I do some of the work, Ralph. Of course, it's needless to say, I'm not in shape to really do a good hard day's work anymore. But
are you telling me your health is bad?
No, but I'm just not in shape like I should be. You know, that a musician's life is not prone for healthy and vigorous exercise. But I try to get out as much as I can, and I do some of the work. But some of the heavier work I have to leave to the younger fellows. But I do love it. It's quiet and peaceful, and it gives me a chance to relax.
Do you ride a lot?
No, haven't ridden but once since I've had the ranch.
You're kidding. You got all those horses and just you don't ride any of them?
Well, I have one favorite horse to ride, but I just don't get that much chance to ride. And I'm always all over the place looking to see what's happening. And we've got so many things going on down there, you know.
What's the horse's name?
The horse's name is her, and it's Shasta Cash. She's a champion quarter mare that I have.
Are all your horses thoroughbred horses?
All but three. I have three quarter mares.
Now, you know, you know what a Sooner dog is.
Yeah, you bet.
Many varieties.
Right.
Are there horses like that?
Yes, there's several breeds. Many breeds. Many different breeds.
Crossbred horses.
And a lot of crossbreds, but there's a lot of pure strains. And, of course, a lot of people raise them. They specialize in, like, the Morgan horse, the Arabian horse, and the quarter horse. And then, of course, there's the Opelousas, and there's so many that it's hard to really really name them off.
You raise the racing type.
I raise the racing thoroughbred, right.
All right, here's the Charlie Pride Band. They have an album out that's new, and here's a little tune for you. That's the Charlie Pride Band. Charlie lives in Dallas, doesn't he, Ray?
Right. That's how you have to, what kind of a weapon you have to use sometime to get your money after a date.
What part of Dallas does Charlie live in?
Charlie lives right down the street from me.
He also lives in North Dallas?
Right. Charlie's one of my neighbors.
I see. Did people get upset when he moved into the neighborhood?
I don't think so.
Years ago, they would have called that block busting.
Right. No, I've never heard anyone complain. In fact, he's a very well-liked person in our neighborhood.
I'm sort of asking that question in jest. I heard he had no problems.
No, he doesn't have any problems. He really doesn't. Everybody's real nice. And
they're probably afraid he'll buy the neighborhood.
That's right. He might buy them out.
You've heard the Charlie Pride Band. That's an instrumental called the sawed-off shotgun. Measuring for a fence, siding, or a new house calls for the extra length and strength of an outdoor tape, so True Value Hardware Stores suggest the stronger, more flexible Lufkin fiberglass tape. Unlike other tapes with parallel fiberglass strands, its strands are woven together, then coated with tough plastic, so it won't tear, break, or split. Lufkin fiberglass tapes in 50 and 100 foot lengths are priced for just $7.88 at participating True Value Hardware Stores. If I want to find out where the country music stars are performing, I pick up my copy of Music City News. This great country music paper has all the news of country music, plus feature stories and never-before-published pictures of your favorite stars. Start your subscription now. To subscribe, simply put your check or money order for $7 in an envelope and mail it to Ralph Emery, Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee. That's $7 to Ralph Emery, Box 8, Nashville, Tennessee. Most of this particular hour of our show has been taken up with Ray's ranch and Ray's horses. I just wondered if at some of the tracks around the United States, some of your horses are racing this season.
Well, I have two in Juarez that's been doing very well, but I'm just about to stop my racing, and I have to race some of them to prove that I believe enough in the horses that I'm selling that I'll race them myself. It has to be done.
But I presume the main thrust of your business is to sell horses.
Yes, hopefully. See, this is just a new business. I've been in horses for many years, but we're just now branching out to the market end of it.
I want you, Ray, to give me an introduction to Jim Reeves as you remember him.
Well, Gentleman Jim, they used to call him, and of course I remember Jim from Shreveport, Louisiana. And smooth way of delivery, very well liked, and a tremendous star in South Africa, by the way. And He sings a song that is really a great old pop tune we hope everybody likes, called You Belong to Me.
See the pyramids along the Nile, watch the sunrise on a tropic isle. Just remember, darling, all the while, you belong to me. See the marketplace in old Algiers, send me photographs and souvenirs. Just remember, when a dream appears, belong to me. I'd be so alone without you. Maybe you'll be lonesome too and blue. Fly the ocean in a silver plane, see the jungle when it's wet with rain. Just remember, till you're home again, you belong to me. Fly the ocean in a silver plane, the jungle when it's wet with rain. Just remember, till you're home again, you belong.
You know, I always thought there was a parallel in the careers of Jim Reeves and Ray Price, because at a point in his career and in your career, you changed your styles and went to the what we now refer to commonly as the modern country sound. But he went through those that old style of country music, as
right,
you did.
Right.
And I guess he made the transition about 57, 58.
No, I think it was a little later than that, Ralph, wasn't it?
But it was about the same time.
It was about the same time, because I know I started with a big orchestra on a Faith album, and,
right,
which was in 57. It was in the 50s, the late 50s. Yeah, it had to be.
Well, you've heard the immortal Gentleman Jim with You Belong to Me. Now, how about a song from Tanya Tucker?
Child down in South Carolina, soon as a Saturday sun went on down, my folks and sister would go and leave me home all alone, going to that big square dance in town. Well, my old radio would play that old Opry show, so I never got lonesome or blue. I'd fall asleep in my chair and dream that I was right there, just a singing the whole night through. When my folks would come home, they'd be humming a song. Mom would smile and say, "Child, don't you know there ain't a thing in this world to make you fall in love, girl, like the San Antonio Stroll." Well, the day finally come when my mama said, "Hun, it's about time you came with us as well." Well, I had me a time, yes, I danced all the night till they rang that old cracked midnight bell. Then the lights went down low, the fiddler picked up his bow, and he played something stately and slow. And my sister Eileen and her husband to be, they held hands and began to stroll. I've been away for a while, but it still brings a smile when I think of the way that it goes. Now I'll sing it to you just so we both can do that old San Antonio stroll. San Antonio stroll.
That's a good song to play down here in Texas, I guess. Although the setting of the song, strangely enough, is South Carolina. Tanya Tucker with a San Antonio stroll.
Oh, could you hold the elevator? I'm Isabel Larson. Haven't I seen you around the
I'm
building?
I'm Renton. Dr. Renton.
Doctor, say, I have this headache.
No,
me, I use Bayer aspirin. Uh-huh. I mean, I have for years. I mean, for me, Bayer works.
Uh-huh.
Do you specialize, doctor?
Yes, I'm very big on the Italian Renaissance.
The Renaissance. Say, what kind of the Renaissance?
I'm a doctor of art history.
You could get in big trouble giving out medical advice.
Get Bayer aspirin. Use only as directed.
When I awoke, my heart beat so.
That's Johnny Cash singing from the album This Country's Gospel, 31 of the greatest gospel recordings of all time. For this very special album, send your check today to me, Ralph Emery, 110 21st Avenue South, or Box 61, Nashville, Tennessee, 37203.
Again I heard.
We are going to go into a new album by Ray Price. Ray, this is, I believe, the second gospel or religious album in your career.
This is it.
Mm-hmm. And you've got some very nice strings. Where'd you do this album?
Well, I recorded this album in Los Angeles.
Are you a religious individual?
Yes, I am.
Now, I know that question probably is a very personal question. Do you consider yourself a very religious individual?
Well, I try to be.
Why do you record religious music?
Because I think they're the greatest love songs ever written.
Now, this particular song is right to the point. You know, how many of you want to go to heaven, so to speak?
So, well, you know, everybody wants to get to heaven. Nobody wants to die.
That's right. I've heard that said. I presume this is a song you have produced for yourself, too.
Along with Larry Gordon and Larry Mahobrack, who is the arranger on this song.
All right, let's listen to Ray Price and a pretty new song called Say I Do.
Many years have come and gone since he walked upon our ground. They say lies don't last so long, so why's his story hanging round? And why do people stop and pray to a man that's dead and gone? When I ask them, they just say, he's coming back to take me home. Anybody here want to live forever? Say I do. Anybody here want to walk on golden streets? Say I do. Anybody here sick and tired of living like you do? Anybody here want a home with love forever? Say I do. And they say you will never know till you walk up to that man and look into his eyes of love and touch the nail scars in his hand
And then if you can walk away, knowing all he died to do, that's when I'll just have to say, I guess he didn't die for you. Anybody here wanna live forever? Say I do. Anybody here wanna walk on golden streets? Say I do. Anybody here sick and tired of living like you do? Anybody here want a home with love forever? Say I do. Say I do. Say I do. Say I do.
Ray, this is your newest single release, isn't it?
Right.
I can envision a lot of gospel acts and people who sing religious music picking that up. I will make a prediction. This is going to become a standard.
I hope for the sake of first of all for my own sake, but not only that, but because it's a religious song and also because of the writers, everything that's involved. It's, you know, no record is one person's achievement. It's a series of achievements.
You've heard Ray Price on our show with Say I Do. My friends, that's about the end of this show. We thank you very much for listening. Our show presented by Beechnut Chewing Tobacco, by your local True Value hardware stores, and by Bayer Aspirin. And Ray Price, we thank you very much.
Thank you, Ralph. It's nice to be here.
And I'll see you tomorrow.
Right.
You can double park your horse out back there.